The Philippine stock market resumes trade today. It's the third to the last session for the year. We are kicking off from 65.41. We're still down, what, 8.2% for the year? For those keeping score, let's take a look at the best and worst performers so far. I think we have a graphics of the top. There you go, the best performing. On top of that list, up over 120%, is Abacor Capital Holdings. While the worst performing stock for the year so far is All Home, whose share price is down 82%. Joining us now for her market bets, Christina Gabaldon of Sun Life Asset Management. Hi, Christina. Merry Christmas. Hey. Welcome to Market Edge.
Thanks for having me again.
All right. So I want to start with your position. What is your play for next year? Are you going to go short on equities, maybe longer on credit and treasuries? Or, I mean, do investors want to go short given the uncertainties that 2023 brings? What's the strategy here?
Okay, so just want to reiterate our index target for 2022. So we, our call is 6876. Hopefully we see that Santa rally and index ends up at that level. For 2023, our index call is 7844. Our EPS expectation next year is 519.64. If you recalled, our EPS growth in 2022 is 18.5%. So far, the nine-month 2022 core weighted EPS growth is at 33%, so way ahead of our expectation of 18.5%. That's why our EPS for 2023 has been bumped up to such a level. Mm-hmm. So our PE multiple for our index target in 2023 is 15.1 times. If you look at earnings yield to bond yield now, it's at 6,500, it is at 12.5 times PE, translating to 7.94% earnings yield. Comparing that to the 10-year government securities of net rate of 5.52, there's like over 240 basis point spread. So with that kind of spread, I think there's room for equities in one's portfolio. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. In terms of government securities, I would go on the longer end of the curve. If inflation peaks, then I would benefit more and with the bond rally. So that's how I would position.
What about holding cash? Does holding cash today make more sense? I mean, if things are expected to, I mean, macro speaking, not financial markets, but macro speaking, some are expecting things to get worse next year. Do you think holding cash would be wise and, you know, just save for a rainy day?
I think yes. Have a portion in cash. Actually, put it in time deposits, which offer good yields right now.
Ah, what's the yield for time deposit these days?
Well, it depends on the AUM, but I've seen ranges from like 6% and up.
All right. Gabs, we earlier showed a list of 2022's best and worst performing stocks. There, we're showing it now. I'm not sure if you can see. Topping that list of best performers is Abacor Capital Holdings, up 126%. Holders of this share must be having a great year. Prime Media Holdings up by 67%. Semirada Mining and Power still up there, up 64%. Year to date, Leisure and Resorts World, Now Corporation, DMCI Holdings, Agri Nurture, DFNN, SSI Group, and PhilWeb are all top 10 best performing stocks. The worst performers, you've got All Home. Who else? All Day Marts, Vista Land, Ayala Land Logistics, Converge. Wow, it's down 56%. Mm-hmm. EEI, Basic Energy, Apollo Global, Medco Holdings. When you look at these names that are at the extreme ends of performance for this year, is there one name that leaps out to you?
I would say for 2023, mm-hmm. it might not be the same names, but I'll go on sectors. So we still like the banks.
Okay.
We think there's still going to be good loan growth. Mm-hmm. We're not seeing any asset quality issues or deterioration at the moment. Mm-hmm. some upside on the sector could be from the removal of credit card caps, which would benefit smaller banks.
That's happening next year? The cap for credit card rates?
Maybe.
Okay.
Yeah, right. But yeah, we still prefer the bigger banks. Mm-hmm. For Conglos, there are certain Conglos that are trading at deep discounts. And if you expect foreign investors to come back into the country, they would buy the usual Conglo names that represent the Philippine economy.
All right. So I'm very curious. I'm not sure if you're happy to share this, but I'm curious, what's the best performing name on your portfolio this year?
I'd rather not share that here. I think it should be, it's our secret.
All right. Let's go over some interesting corporate stories then. I want to start with McDonald's Philippines. Of course, Andrew Tan has a stake here, JDC, and of course, Mr. George Yang. They just opened their 700th store in New Valley. Wow, that's 700 different McDonald's stores all over the Philippines. It's the fast food segment, also a consumer play. How's the consumption play looking like for 2023? I mean, inflation staying high, interest rates are still elevated, we're expecting a slowdown in the economy. What are you expecting on the consumption side? Because this is a big consumption play.
Yeah, so for quick service restaurants, SSSG, same store sales growth should taper off given some limitation, of course, in pent-up demand in the higher base. Mm-hmm. But it's good that they are expanding outside of Metro Manila, which might have better growth.
All right. And what about this? Aquila Land Development is partnering with the Armed Forces of the Philippines for the retirement side of AFP. They're going to be developing a 57-hectare low-cost housing project in Mexico. Pampanga, the property, you know, property industry, it doesn't usually do well in a high interest rate environment. We're expecting interest rates to stay elevated next year. Are you staying away from property plays?
Well, for this case, I think there's a backlog in, you know, economic housing segment, socialized housing, and low-cost housing segment till 2030. So as long as it's affordable, then great. It's good for the buyers, right? If terms are made favorable. But in general, of course, higher interest environment would be a challenge for, let's say, residential segments.
All right. Gabs, we have this, Justin, and I wanted to bring this story up. Enrique Lizon's ICTSI, the port operator, well, they're buying Marubeni Corporation's 20% share in BIPI. BIPI is the Bawan International Port Inc. So Enrique Lizon is buying 20% of that Bawan International Port for 507 million pesos. BIPI, of course, operates the Bawan Terminal, which is approximately 120 kilometers south of Manila and 9 kilometers west of Batangas. It supports cargo movements in and out of Cavite, Laguna, Batangas, Rizal, Quezon area, or Calabarzon. I just want to get your take. Enrique Lizon seems to be on a roll this year. Are you liking his stocks?
ICT has been performing, actually, even with concerns on in 2023. So far, 2022 is a fantastic year for them. Also, they've been resilient, and with tariff increases, they have benefited. Them buying into this probably has some synergies in current port operations.
All right. And we've come to the most exciting part of the conversation, the blind item. Talk to us about the stock that you're monitoring closely. I think you like this stock. Don't tell us, just describe. We're going to leave our viewers to guess what this is. So what do you have for us today?
So this stock is likely to be included in the index come February 2023. Mm-hmm. It's within the top 25 names in the PSEI in terms of market cap and has acceptable value turnover. Mm-hmm. So it's potentially an index inclusion come February. So far, 9-month 22 earnings is up 105%. So this name is in the mining, power, and construction, and real estate.
Okay, you're giving it away, Gabs. Okay, go on.
But the mining segment and power segment did really well, and expected dividend yield for this name is at 10.64%. Of course, the risk here is that if commodity prices correct and WSM prices correct and goes downward, they would be affected.
All right. We're showing the price chart for this stock. It's one of the best performers, actually, for this year. What sort of upside can investors look? Because it's looking pretty top-ish if you look at the last 3 years of performance.
I think it's a good short-term trade. So far, it's trading at 10.88% discount to its NAV.
All right, 10.88% discount versus its NAV. We're just going to have to guess which stock this is, but I think many people are going to get this. Thank you very much, Gabs, for joining us. Always a pleasure. It's been a pleasure, you know, parsing through market news with you this year. We look forward to more good news for 2023. See you next year.
See you next year. Happy New Year, Mimi.
Happy New Year.